So this pool is the telling about the Old Testament. He says that go wash yourself in the pool of Siloam. So whatever my brothers and sisters written in the Bible is fulfillment from the Old Testament. So this is the pool of Siloam in the book of John. It's written here, and many others, other prophet like a prophet Ezekiel, he also taking the ritual bath in the pool of Siloam. Let's show some pics. The next pool. So this is the pool of Siloam in the time of Moses, when this and after the time of David, the time of Solomon. This pool are very beautiful. So this is the seer, and this is the palace real near about the palace of David. It's look like this is a very beautiful pool, but from time to time when the destruction, and you know the Ezekiel, even Ezekiel take the ritual bath in the pool of Siloam. But right now this pool is look like this in the right now in the Jerusalem. So even this is the water of Gion and Ezekiel Junal pool. So these pools are also now present in the Israel. Next one. And you know there is this pool of Siloam. If you see in the New Testament, when one person is sitting in the pool of Siloam, 38 years he is sitting, and he says that when the angels from heaven, and he just touch the water, and many people come inside the pool, they become healed. So when Jesus Christ come and he says that what you want, I will do for you. Jesus Christ touches people and he become a healed. In that time, these pools are a holy pool. These pools are you can say the anointing in these pools. So many sick people, lame people, blind people, they are sitting in front of these pools. And the pool of Siloam is the one of the pools which are the anointed, and the many angels are once in a year or once in a month comes and they are touched the people when they come in front of. So this is the baptism of Jesus Christ. When Jesus Christ taking the water baptism, he never give us a new theory. He is telling asking us for the righteousness of God, and we take a ritual bath. So if we see upper pool, it's written here, upper pool is Isaiah chapter 7 verse 3. Blood pool is talking about Exodus chapter 7 verse 19. I will give you little recap. Blood pool, what is the blood pool? It's written here in Exodus chapter 7 verse 19. You can read when you have a time. It's talking about, you know, when God commanded to the Moses, go and tell the Moses, let my people go to leave to Egypt. But when Pharaoh is taking in the bath, he's taking the bath in the pool, and Moses, what he'll take? Moses take a pot and he put in the pool, and the pool becomes blood, and the all the pool of in that time in the Pharaoh's time is come blood, and from that time to today this pool is called the blood pool. And the Lord pool and the pools in one pool. Let's open somebody John chapter 3 verse 23. This pool is talking about John baptizing also in this pool. John chapter 3 verse 23. John chapter 3 verse 23. John chapter 3 verse 23. Baptizing them. This was before John had been put in prison. take a ritual bath in that pool. And this is the pool of Gibeon and the first Samuel chapter 2 verse 13. In the time of Samuel, when he anointed the people, or when he was baptizing the people, when he was giving the bath or ritual bath in that pool. But today this pool are dry, and this pool are dry, and this pool are you can say destroyed because of war, first war, second war. But today this pool are same like this and remain on that ground. So it's a 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 13. You can read also. When you have a time, you can note down the words, the pool of Jeroboam. So these all pools, my brothers and sisters, also in today in the land of in the Jordan, in the Jerusalem, and in Israel, the pool of Bethesda and pool of